name is Jeoffrey Curtis, owner of the Twisted Chopstick Sushi Bar. Today I'm going to show you how to make some salmon guacamole and a yakitori poke bowl. So let's get started. Lemon, which you can get at any grocery store. And that's good for the salmon guac right there. And we're going to move over to frying up the lotus root chips or sweet potatoes. Now we're going to prepare some sweet potatoes for our salmon guacamole. If you don't have a deep fryer like we have here, you can just take a pot and put some vegetable oil in it about halfway, get it to 350 degrees, and just use a tempura, and you'll be all good to go. Coat it, and drop it in. And they're gonna go for about 5 minutes, so you can get them nice and crispy. Now we're gonna plate our salmon guacamole. Salmon guacamole. Now we're going to start on the marinade for the yakitori poke bowl. You're going to get it to a rolling boil. And after it's done boiling, you're gonna add a little bit of your light beer. So we're gonna get that to a boil. I'll let it simmer for about 10 minutes after you add the beer. And after that, you turn off the heat. And once it's cooling down, you can add your thickening agent, which we have the potato starch mixed with some water. And we'll wait until that's done. All right, now after we have our marinade, we're gonna marinate it overnight for about 24 hours, or you can get away with 2 hours, and then you're gonna skewer them with some scallions. It's usually, traditionally, it's a charcoal grill when they're doing it yakitori style, but if you just wanna do it a pan sear, that's also fine. Throw that on there, and you're gonna cook your chicken until it's thoroughly cooked. Here we do it for about 10 to 15 minutes on the grill. So now we're going to be assembling our yakitori poke bowl. We're going to start with our rice. I have here sushi rice that has vinegar, sugar, some salt, but you can use any steamed rice as well. So you're going to put that on the bottom, just like so. You're going to take your green sprouts, assemble it. You're going to go in a circle around the vegetables, so when we're done, the chicken can go on top. That looks perfect, so we're going to take it from the grill or pan, put it on top of our poke bowl, just like that. I took the sauce that we marinated it with and reduced it down even further so we could use it as a sauce for on top of the poke bowl. There you have it, the yakitori poke bowl.